started off many, many years ago with framework programs, and that framework programs continued recently in Horizon 2020. And that really gives great opportunities to on any subject to set up partnership. And in these kinds of projects, you team up and you try to address a topic. And what's really neat is that Europe is really going in the direction of solving societal challenges. And I think that's the link also to the initiative that we are working on.
We have about 100 partners, and besides that, we have the support, the backing, besides of the Romanian government, who's putting it the biggest chunk of money. We have the support from 10 other governments or funding organizations in Europe. During the last centuries, since humans started meddling a lot with nature, any intervention was either sectorial and solving a problem along the drainage basin, along a river catchment, but move the problem to the sea, or solve the sector but generated losses in other aspects, or solve everything in a stretch of a river sea system but move the problems either downdrift or downstream. And if you want some very clear examples, building dams have been a glorious period like 100 years ago because they generated electricity and they solved locally flood problems. But after 100 years or 50 years or 60 years, we can look back and see that actually dams, yes, solved some problems locally and upstream, but generated massive problems downstream. We are talking about species of fish and other organisms that used to migrate from rivers upstream the seas, and their cycles have been severely cut. We are talking about the ways to address pollutants and to have harnessed somehow human development in a way that doesn't juggle too much with nature.
The better we understand the functioning of the systems and our interventions, the better we are capable in responding. On the scientific part, it's fragmented. So this is our attempt to bring on the science part together. But also you see European policy is sectorial. We have for the rivers, we have the Water Framework Directive. We have to, for the sea, you have the Marine Strategy Framework Directive. But actually, it's not really combining and working together. Although the last 2 years, the water directors, the marine directors, and even the biodiversity directors in Europe said, if you want to achieve our goals that we have set, we need to work together, we need to team up, we need to integrate approach, Water Framework Directive connected to a Marine Strategy Framework Directive. And I think our initiative can be a big means in the future to deliver the science and the fundamental understanding for that.
We want to make it, and we shall make it operational in 2022 from now on. But when this will be operational, we shall be the one-stop shop in all you need looking in high level of science in river, sea, and focusing also on transitional zones between rivers and seas. And what we want to do is to provide sound data, sound expertise, to be the platform where all the companies, innovative companies, will come to find solutions, test new ideas, and further strengthen the public-private partnership. But access will be given based on excellent ideas. Yeah.